Welcome back to the SNHU weekly podcast. My name is Giovanni. I am a freshman at SNHU online. I am majoring now in data analytics with a minor in project management for STEM. So let me first get this out of the way, because you're probably wondering with the title of this video, what happened? Why did I change my major? I'll get that out the way. Then we will talk about a couple of things. We will talk about, obviously, my change in major. We're going to talk about the grade check like normal. We're going to go over weeks 4 short answer grade and feedback, if there was any. And as well, there were 2 things. There was also a project draft, and I really want to go over some details with you. So this one will be really short, but let's get started. First things first, let's talk about the change in the major and why that happened. So I looked at what my long-term goal is, which is to have my master's degree in data analytics. In order to do that, as I was starting to research those classes, so I'll give you a bit of details on that. So we'll just go into what this will matter. So this is the new degree path. Okay, so we're still in our freshman year. We are still taking our classwork, like our general education classwork right now. We haven't started any like major data analytics work. So this was the perfect time to change. So we'll go into just a breakdown of the bachelor's in data analytics. As you guys know, if you've been following this channel for a little bit or looking at some of my previous videos, we've already taken DAT 220, we've taken IT 140, and we've taken some other general education courses that are required. And so that's where we were. So as I was starting to look at this coursework versus my coursework in cybersecurity, I would not have been prepared for my major, or excuse me, my master's later on, because I did not have the correct undergraduate. So that's what made me make the decision. And so I had a conversation with my, like the career counselors. I had a conversation with my advisor just to make sure my mindset was in the right place. Thankfully, one thing I do want to say, the advisor that was there to help me when I called, my original advisor wasn't there. She was out of the office. So I talked to another advisor, and he was really helpful because he was explaining about how when he got his undergraduate and then went on to get his master's, the school he went to would not even allow him to take the coursework, because if he had not taken his undergraduate, to be focused in what he was doing. So this is where we will be going. These courses right here align with what will happen when you get to the master's level. So if you notice, these classes go up to 475. Okay, so at that point, at 475, that's your undergraduate level. So when you start to get to your master's level and you start looking at, and I know most people are probably going like, why is that important? It is important to know where you want to go before you at least start. I started the journey, and I've moved along as I go through. So data analytics are offered in basically 4 different places. So I could focus on marketing, I could focus on information technology, if that's what I want to do, or just a flat out master's in data analytics. That's where we came to. And if you look at this coursework, even if you were to just do the regular data analytics course, okay, the master's in data analytics, you'll look here and you'll see now, as master's level, which is normal, these classes are in the 600 range. And some of the things that you would need in order to get accepted to this program, which I later found out, in order to get accepted to this master's program, there are certain prerequisites that you need to have done, which on cybersecurity side, I would not have had in order to come to this program. I still would have had to take other classes in order to be even prepared. A lot of math. So not a lot, I shouldn't say, that's an understatement. Not a lot of math, but math is required. So just wanted to get that portion out the way, because I know people are going to be looking at this and going, why did you change your majors? I think you guys are owed an explanation. So let's now move on to what's happening in the current coursework. Look at the grade check first, like we normally do. Let's start with the grade check. So for grade check, we're still at an A, 505 out of 520. And that is because instead of getting an A on one of our papers, we got a B. And I will explain the feedback that I received and took from it. So as you guys get ready to develop and go through these classes, you can understand what the instructor is looking for. This is specific to my instructor, does not necessarily mean that your instructor will be the same way, but this at least gives you transparency. So the short answer portion was just doing like a regular post, and I did the research for this one was monument as a cultural work. And so as the monument for the cultural work, I chose the Martin Luther King Memorial, and that was my monument. And then I went through and wrote a paper about the monument. And so that was the short answer portion that you needed. All right. So now the project draft. Now, there are a couple of things, as you can see, with the project draft. And for those that are on the podcast, the instructor, so out of 95 points, I received 80.75 out of 95 points because of a couple of things. So the feedback that was provided, basically to sum up all of this, is that my project draft was not long enough. And the second thing was that the project feedback that I received, in particular on the rubric, so each one of these she expounds on what you could do better in order to take this to the maximum points. But where I got 0 points on it was here. And it says the ideas that needed attribution did not include citations. You can find guides within the Shapiro library to help you explain citation format with examples. So then she is guiding you towards, here's how you can learn how to do this course in APA. This was the first time I actually took my resources off. Every other page, every other time I've turned in a paper, I've always turned in a paper with resources. This was the time I took them off. And that cost me in the grade portion. But I'm not worried about my grade being in jeopardy. We have a couple of weeks and our main project is due, our 200 point project is due in week 7. So as we're going through this, I just wanted to give you guys full transparency, what's going on. And that's basically it. That's the whole week of classwork that we had. We are moving on to 5. I've actually answered 5 and did 5's work, but haven't received any feedback on them yet. So once that's done, of course, next week, we'll go over this information and I'll give you more information as I find out. Hit that like button, pass it on to someone who might be going through this coursework or consider it. And I'll see you guys next week. Bye.